On July 4th, 1776, the US declared its independence and 11 years later ratified the original Constitution, the core document of our country. This document introduced a three-branch government. It afforded certain rights and responsibilities to states, but it also got a few things wrong. The framers agreed to count black people as only 3/5 of a person and didn't even mention women, who had to fight for the right to vote well over a century after the Constitution's ratification. This country was built on a framework that didn't meaningfully contemplate equality based on race or gender or sexual orientation. But one of the essential pieces of the Constitution was an article allowing for the amendment of the supreme law of this country, an article allowing for potential. To me, the potential of America is its ability to admit its wrongs and grow to become greater and more just than it ever has been before.
America's potential is infinite. Our founding fathers knew that in order for us to be successful or to merely survive, we had to be adaptable.
When I think about everything going on in our country today and all of the division and lack of acceptance there is, I think about all of America's potential to be so much better than what it is now.
The potential to achieve here cannot be understated. We have the power to form a more perfect union by further embracing the dreams of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the DACA recipients, the young girl in STEM, or the young boy in the arts.
We have seen time and time again what has gotten America through trying times is not division, but unity.
Growing up in a military family, I have so much pride in this country and so much passion for who we are as well as who I know we can be.
To me, America's potential means being able to achieve your true potential.
That we are eager to listen to one another and eager to make change that benefits one another.
It looks like all of us as Americans realizing that we lose nothing and we gain everything by all of us having equal opportunity in this country.
America's potential is a highly resourced country that has the means and political devices to create a truly equal society.
I'm very proud to be an American where I have the opportunity and the duty to use not only my voice, but also my vote to advocate for positive change in our nation.
We can't maximize America's potential by disenfranchising certain groups of people who have so much to offer to our country.
I believe that we can be a place where no one is discriminated against because of the color of their skin, because of their race, their religion, their ethnicity, their sexual orientation.
The greatest thing about America is that the people hold the power. From voting to freedom of speech to working with our legislators, we have the power to shape the future of this country based on the needs that we see today.
I think America's potential lies in the realization that what we can do is limitless. We have the opportunity to use our voice, resources, and strength to ignite incredible change and pave way for a better and more united future.
Earlier this year, I saw a magazine cover that said Youthquake, how the world will change when the new generation leads. Well, that's us. America's potential is our responsibility.
So if we continue to preserve, to improve, and to make our system of democracy work for us, our potential as individuals and together as a country is limitless.
When we are talking about the potential of America, to me, that means a place we can all truly experience our right to the pursuit of happiness.
I believe in America because we have great dreams and the opportunity to make those dreams come true. America has a lot of potential, but there is still a lot of work to do.
I think that the United States has limitless potential because we the people have limitless ambition and we see the opportunity to really make an impact.
America is a melting pot of people, and I think that that is America's potential to truly be a place of equality and unity.
The very men who wrote, "All men are created equally," we're not practicing that phrase, and we're a part of the inhumane treatment of other human beings, selling them as property, and the oppression of women. I'm so thankful for how far we've come as a nation, and I am so thankful to see people's hearts move to want to see more change as we move forward.
We need more dialogue and conversations to understand each other, rather than monologues to divide each other.
Because of our liberties and the right to pursue happiness, we can achieve anything. But as our founding fathers very well knew, it comes at a cost.
So when I think about the potential of America, I know we cannot think about that without realizing the value of every single person that makes up this beautiful country we share.
Right now, we are in a time of radical transformation, and if we can all come together, support each other, find similarities, we can work together to become united, and America can reach its limitless potential.